lamp.
There you guys are. What up, everyone? My name is David Franco, and welcome to the weekend of Lockety Vlog. This is going to be a very exciting weekend, mainly because of tech purchases, so that sounds kind of selfish of me, but I promise it's good tech.
And I gotta be honest, today's already Saturday. Okay, so my earliest viewers probably recall, I actually used to start the weekend vlog on Saturdays, and then one day just clicked, I'm like, wait a minute. Make the vlogs longer. Start them on Fridays. But yes, this weekend is definitely the exception because I've been so freaking busy in here throughout the past 24 hours or so. Alright, hold on. Let's do a quick recap of this week just to give you guys an idea of how busy I truly was. I mean, guys, I have not streamed on Twitch once all week. I'm basically taking the entire week off. So Monday into Tuesday, Monday I woke up at 5 a.m. I worked in Philly overnight with my dad. Got home Tuesday around 6 p.m. I had so much work to catch up. Not that much work, but I wanted to edit the Pigeons Only vlog and stuff like that just to get a head start on things. And then on Wednesday, I vlogged more and more and more. And I actually vlogged into the late hours of the night because I decorated my dad's office Christmas tree with the family. So I vlogged that in the Pigeons Only vlog. So I had to come home, edit that to like, what, 2-3 in the morning. And then I previewed the vlog Thanksgiving morning at the parents' house, which I don't think I've ever had to do that, but I was just so tight on time. And then Thursday, of course, I enjoyed all day with the family, had lots of food and all that good stuff. Thursday night into early Friday morning, like midnight, we went Gray Thursday shopping, Black Friday shopping. Got myself an insane thing. If you haven't seen it yet, you'll see it in a minute, all right? Relax yourself. I vlogged on Friday, but it was technically Friday morning, like midnight into 1 in the morning. And now, yesterday was Friday. Yesterday, I edited all day. I mean, I took a break. I went to the parental's house to watch The Office. We got some coffee at Rutter's, and I had another turkey dinner. I had two turkey dinners last night. Not that much, but, you know, enough to fill me up. And then I came back last night, finished Thanksgiving 2019 part one. You know, hold on, look at this. It's just much better to show you. Thanksgiving 2019 part one. Thanksgiving 2019 part two. Thanksgiving 2019 part three. Black Friday 2019. And of course, if we go to my actual YouTube channel. Oh, look at that, look at that. Christmas graphics are back, I love it. And I also have Thanksgiving is next. That's the weekend vlog I published yesterday. And from Philly to Thanksgiving, 1 hour and 7 minutes worth of footage for the patrons only of Lockety Vlog. So in other words, guys, I have been extremely busy, just balancing the Philly job Monday to Tuesday, then hanging out with the family on Thanksgiving and just trying to spend a lot of time with them. And then just editing. And no, this is not my way of looking for empathy. I don't need that. I'm just saying I'm a hard worker, especially around the holidays. I put the time in. It is my top priority to get these videos out for early access patrons. And actually, patrons are getting 1, 2, 3, 4 videos today, which of course includes Thanksgiving 2019 part 1, part 2, and part 3, as well as Black Friday 2019. A lot of content. And I'm going out today to vlog another Black Friday experience. Today's Saturday. But, yeah, I have something pretty exciting that I might be purchasing today, and it could be a first kind of experience for me. I'll explain that in a bit. I am going to relax for a bit, have my coffee, publish these vlogs for patrons and all that stuff. And by the way, not gonna overplug my Patreon, but I really do want you guys to know, Patreon is a life changer for me, and if you want early access to all of my Christmas videos, it's $2 a month. $2. This time last year, I believe it was $5. So $2 a month, you get early access to all this Christmas content. And I'm talking all of it. Except for the Christmas countdown, that's exclusive to 5 and up. But yeah, I mean, for $2 a month, you get access to a lot of content. And it's an amazing way of supporting my channel because advertising revenue is terrible. just terrible. This time last year, I was making two times what I'm making now. I'm not going to talk about exact numbers today, but I'll talk about exact numbers starting in January and February. That's a big goal of mine in 2020, is to be super transparent with you guys. So yeah, let's make today a good day. I'm going to have my coffee, get some sausage in me. You know, sausage as in food, not human sausage. I don't roll that way, but hey, if you do, more power to you. I don't judge. Seriously though, today should be another busy day. Let's do it. Hello, sir. How's your Thanksgiving? Maui, you read my mind. I am leaving soon. I'm getting out of here. I am on a mission. Hey guys, good news.
It's 2 o'clock.
Not only is it 2 o'clock, thank you, Mr. McIntosh. What a classic saying. But early access to both series is now live. Thank you so much for your support, guys. Thank you for allowing me to work around the clock. It's because of your support. It's just what drives me, you know? It's what drives me and motivates me to work harder and faster. Okay, so now that that's done, cheers, everyone, to good content. My main priority today is to buy... Hold on. I'm watching Nightmare on Elm Street. I've been, like, in a big horror mood lately. I know, nothing says holidays more than people getting gutted to death. Isn't it grand? I just love it. Anyway, I want to buy a Nest Hub Max today. Well, okay, come here. First of all, if you have not been keeping up with my content, check out what I got on Black Friday, guys. Oh my god, this is not something I expected to buy. And guys, I am not being sarcastic or exaggerative when I say this. These things were flying off the pallet. I got mine, and then there were two left after that. These things were just flying off. $278. Philips, which isn't my go-to brand. My go-to brand is usually Samsung. But guys, look at this. I have a Sharp TV in here right now, which isn't my go-to brand either, but I got a great deal on that years ago. But guys, $278. Philips, which is a good brand. 65-inch, 4K, Android TV, which should be interesting, because I don't think I've ever had an Android TV before. I'm not sure. At least I don't think I have. Either way, I'm excited. And it does have HDR. This is not Insignia, guys. This is not TCL. This is not your typical Black Friday deal. I mean, sure, it's not as great as Samsung. Samsung's still my favorite brand. Got one right up there. I love that TV. But for $278, 65-inch, I could not... I just couldn't walk away from this TV. I mean, I honestly would have felt so stupid to myself for not buying this for such a cheap price. So what will I be doing with this TV? Going in the basement. I have big plans for the basement. Let's just say, as much as I love the holidays, TV was dusty. January is going to be a very exciting month for me. I'm going to redo my bedroom, at least this portion of it. This is a pretty well-sized bedroom, so I can do a lot. My bed's gonna stay here, which is currently a mess. Don't look. But yeah, this is gonna be more modern. I'm gonna buy like a nice TV stand. All this stuff's gonna come out of the corners or whatever. It just looks too childish in here. I'm gonna finally get these clothes under control. Look at this. Guys, sign of a true geek. I just have tech boxes sitting around the house. A Dell box, Go XLR, gaming headset, Corsair. And I have boxes downstairs as well. But obviously, I'm going to get that cleaned up in time for the party, which is, by the way, 2 weeks from today. 2 weeks until the Christmas party. So yeah, I'm going to unbox this today. I'm hoping it fits on here. Again, it's not going to stay on here because that would just look stupid. This, I believe, is a 50-inch TV, and it just makes it. It just makes it on the stand. So obviously, a 65-inch TV is going to hang off quite a bit. But it should support the weight just fine. But yeah, today I'm going to go online and do some shopping. So going back to my original thought, I really want the Nest Hub Max, which, by the way, I found out actually works as a dedicated Nest Cam. I don't know why I never thought about that. I just thought the camera was used for like video calls and taking pictures. But because it's Nest, you can actually use it as a dedicated Nest Cam. It's not as cool as a dedicated Nest Cam. Well, because it doesn't have night vision and you can't adjust the angle. But considering it's going to be in the corner of my kitchen, right over there, I'm excited. So over the weekend, I saw someone in the condos that I tested with my dad. They had a larger Echo Show. And I was like, wait a minute, a larger screen really does look better in the kitchen.
And well, come on, I have a... I'll see, it's going to be a little expensive. I have a Nest thermostat here
and a Nest thermostat upstairs. So it only makes sense to integrate as many Google products as possible. And in the near future, I'm hoping to get a Nest Hello doorbell. I have a Ring Video doorbell, which I haven't opened yet, but I'm sure I can find a use for that somewhere. So anyway, what makes this so unique? Because I can buy a Nest Hub Max any day, right? Well, first of all, I'm getting it for $30 off, which is cool. Not an insane discount. It's not as exciting as my TV. But the thing is, I want to buy it from Target, which as of last night only had two left in the color I want, the white one. But the thing is, I want to buy it using Target's drive-up service, which is exactly what it sounds like. And I want to vlog the entire experience. Okay, so this is how it works. Let me turn this brightness down for you guys. And by the way, I am using the Osmo action camera, which I love, but it is a fixed focus, so close subjects like this are always going to be blurry. Anyway, let's search for the Nest Hub Max. Hopefully they have it in stock still. Please be in stock in white. Okay, good. Okay, good. Actually, what I prefer to do is go to Target.com and search for the Nest Hub Max. Because for some reason, the app doesn't tell you how many are left. I'm not sure why, but on the website it does. So check it out. Let's go to recently viewed products in the search. Nest Hub Max. Turn the brightness down on this too. There it is. That's the exact one I want with the gray, whites. Oh, yep. Two left still. Only two left. The thing is, it's not an insanely popular product because it's not the cheapest product. The cheaper one is definitely the regular Google Nest Hub, which is only $79. That's a steal. That's an absolute steal. But what's interesting at the same time is the Nest Hub Max in charcoal, you know, in other words, black, is sold out. But guys, honestly, that's fine because this is the exact model I want. So there's two left. So let's try this out. Let's buy it on the app. So here we go. Google Nest Hub Max Chalk, it's called. $199. And let's do Lancaster East pickup ready within 2 hours. So this is fine. Drive up. We bring it out to your car. So apparently, and I've watched a couple of videos on it, a Target employee comes out to your car within 2 minutes of you saying that you're there, because it has some kind of beacon technology built in, which is actually quite cool. And they bring it out to you in a bag. Think like DoorDash, but you're actually at Target and they bring your stuff out to you. Okay, so obviously I don't mind going in and getting it. It's not a laziness thing. I just want to test this. And plus, the Nest Hub Max is kind of like a specialty item, meaning it's behind glass. So in a way, this is definitely saving me some time. And well, I just want to try Drive Up. I haven't tried it, and we've had Drive Up at our Target for a few months now. I'm very, very curious. Okay, so let's go to my cart. There's only two in there because I was playing around with this last night. So there's one. In my cart, Lancaster East, ready within 2 hours. And I'm going to check out and let you guys know when it's ready to be picked up. Face ID. Actually, I have to change my debit card because I don't think I've ever ordered from the Target app before. So give me 1 minute. All right, there you go. Get ready for your fastest Target run ever. You will receive an email when your drive-up order is ready. Check your order status anytime right here in the Target app. God, I love convenience. Today's world is incredible, guys. Just incredible. Speaking of incredible, hey, Zero.
Heating up my coffee.
And yeah, I know. I'm probably going to have a few people saying, David, but it's Christmas. Stop buying yourself things. Hey, there's nothing wrong with treating yourself. First of all, I did not expect to get that TV on Friday nights, not at all. That was a nice surprise. So I was gonna buy the Nest Hub Max regardless. But after this, I'm done. From this point forward, I'm officially Christmas shopping for everyone but myself. And I actually have a list together already of things I wanna buy. My mom, dad, I think I have a couple things for Kristen in my Shutterfly cart and all that stuff. I love Shutterfly. Shutterfly's incredible. Mary, come here, what are you doing? Okay, so that's done. I'm gonna keep you guys updated. So we're gonna go shopping later, and I'm going to Walmart as well because I want to do some in-person Christmas shopping for people other than myself. So hopefully I'll get a few gifts for people today. And I get paid by Patreon next week, so I guess next week's like the real shopping week for me. So today I'll probably get a few smaller things. Also, look at that. Only one left. So the other one was obviously mine, which is cool. That tells me it instantly updates. Because I don't always trust the inventory number on websites, but it's cool to see that Target is pretty much instant. And side note, for my fellow Christmas freaks, stay tuned. My Countdown to Christmas 2019 series starts tomorrow, December 1st. I love it. Cannot wait. For 24 days straight, I will be building a separate Lego figure or something each and every day. And shout out to my friend Ellie again. Each and every day alongside the Lego advent calendar, I'll be eating a piece of chocolate. Apparently this is good chocolate, so I'm excited. And I need to get started on this year's YouTube holiday collaboration video. Yeah, I mean, last night it kind of hit me. I'm like, wait, that time of the year is here. So I got to get started on details. But actually, I might do that now. This is a very, very busy time of the year for me, but I love it. All right. A YouTube holiday 2019 is ready to go. I just have to design the graphic. But if you guys are interested in participating, please click the link right below. It means a lot to me. It takes 30 seconds of your day, maybe 60 seconds, depending on how many takes and how much you want to talk. But seriously, this is a big deal to me. So if you appreciate community and you appreciate the holidays and you have something to share, please click that link right below. I'm not begging you. I'm just encouraging you because this is a video that will live forever. And yes, I actually do mean forever. Eventually, one day when YouTube is no more, and that won't be for a long time. Yes, I actually still have the videos myself, and I will always and forever keep them and share them somehow. So as you can probably see, it's a big deal to me. Thank you. I think that's a good graphic for this year. It's consistent with last year's design. Different colors. Rotated the snowflakes a little bit. Changed the gradients just a smidge on the 2019. YouTube holiday literally didn't change. But by consistency, I mean this.
There's nothing here.
Let me go to my YouTube channel. And boom, look at that. It's good, right? Consistency is everything. I love it. And it's already 3 o'clock. Oh!
Where is it?
Your drive up order. Ready for drive up! Your order is ready at Target Lancaster East, which is open until 11 p.m. Let us know when you're on your way. Woo! Yes! Got so excited I'll sneeze there, y'all! I'm gonna head out soon then. I'm gonna go out while it's still light out. And I'm gonna hit up Walmart. Told you guys that already, didn't I? Yeah. I'm probably gonna talk about. I'm stopping Rutter's on the way for coffee. Today's gonna be a good old solo shopping day. Yo, I'm excited for drive up. Also, one thing I didn't mention before, you guys know me, I love change, I love mixing it up. So, my goal by. It's another postcard I gotta send out for Patreon. My goal for 2020, one of my goals, I think by February or March, realistically, is I want to completely redo this office. I want to build it better for productivity. I love this desk. I love it so much. IKEA Jerker. It's probably my favorite desk of all time. I've had it in what? 4 houses now? Maybe 5 houses? It's that good. Seriously, it's so good. And I got it for $99. Unfortunately, IKEA doesn't make it anymore. But it's just a solid desk. Anyway, getting into my points, I will be keeping that desk, but it might be going in the basement. And I want to get a desk that's built more realistically for this office, or several desks. I might have desks going around the walls. That way, different stations, or maybe something like this, or like an L shape. I don't know. But I also need a desk with a ton of depth. Because I use a 42-inch monitor as my primary display, I can't be sitting like this close. This close is actually kind of perfect. I can see everything within arm's reach, but at the same time, I can't touch it because I'm not within physical arm's reach. So yeah, 2020 is going to be a big, big year for me, guys. I'm hyped. Between my gaming room, receiving more upgrades, I'm sure, but that room is close to done. I mean, it's never truly done, but I've gotten a lot of work done. Between the gaming room and the basement being completely redone, my office being completely redone, and my bedroom receiving some nice upgrades. Oh, and this, the living room being completely redone with my TV from the basement and my speakers from the basement. Everything's going to go over there. My house is going to see a ton of changes. A ton of changes within like the first few months of next year. Okay, let's get ready to head out. My Target drive-up is ready. But first, let's go to Rutter's. Today's going to be a good day. Today's going to be a very, very good day. I'm just feeling hyped. V-Troy's. I think that's a good angle from when I pull up the Target drive-up. That way you can see the person and whatever. I'm at Rutter's. Got my free coffee as usual. I feel bad. They like always give me free coffee. And I even told her. I'm like, I feel bad. But that's exactly why I bought something on the side. Pepper Jack Cheese Tornado. Why not? Why not? Plus, I need food. Crispy. Although, it could be a little hotter. Okay. Mmm. Just a good snack. I just like the overall vibe of today, you know? I'm going out there solo, shopping. Feels good. Alright, I'm gonna get this quick snack in me. Oh. And I need to tell Target I'm on my way. Do that in a second. Alright, here we go. I'm on my way. Vehicle type, SUV, van, wagon, sedan, truck, hatchback, coupe, motorcycle, bicycle, that'd be amazing. Let's just go with sedan. And it's red. Dude, very cool. Parked by the drive-up sign. I'm almost there. This mom in front of me is jamming to her music. She is dancing with her son in the passenger seat. I love happy people like that. Be happy, not miserable. You only live once. Give off good vibes. Love people like that. We're almost there, guys. Got one more light to go through. Well, potentially two. We'll see. Chestnuts roasting on an open fire. Poor Chet. Every year his nuts get roasted. Why? What did Chet do to deserve this? Honestly. Yuletide carols being sung by total copyright this weekend. I don't care. And folks dressed up like Eskimos. God, I love coffee. Everybody knows a turkey and some mistletoe help to make the season bright. Tiny tots with their eyes. I thought he meant tater tots. Got excited there for a second. God, I miss those times. Those years of being a kid and you quite literally could not fall asleep. But nowadays, as an adult, I think most of us naturally fall asleep pretty quickly. I mean, I have my nights here and there where I just toss and turn watching Boy Meets World in the background. I check my iPhone, check my iPad. I get sucked into videos and stuff like that. But lately, I've been very tired because I've been working into like the early hours of the morning, 2, 3, 4 o'clock in the morning. Here we go, guys. Here we go. The last big lights before Target. Don't turn into my lane. Don't turn into my lane. Good job. Let's pick up some speed here. Pass all these cars. Hey, hey, hey. Don't come out. Don't come out. Okay, I have two more lights to go through. I don't count these lights because I don't stop at these lights that often. They're usually green for people on 30. They're usually... That dude is like dancing by the traffic light. I love it. I'm telling you. There's just a vibe going on today. There's a universal vibe. I love it. It's good. Alright. See you guys at Target. I will be there in less than a minute. Okay, this person's confused. That's how accidents happen. You saw it first. Alright, so drive up is over there. Let's get past all this first. Right there is the Amish farm tour. If you guys are ever curious about seeing more of Lancaster, the farms, the Amish, all that stuff.
I mean, I've never done it because I live here, so it's kind of weird to do it myself. Although, maybe one of these days I will. All right, drive up. Here we go. Let's turn into this one, shall we? Doing all this one-handed for the sake of vlogging. Hello. Yeah, that was fast.
You're David, right?
Yeah, that's me.
Cool. We have a few on here, so I just wanted to double check. And if I could get you to sign for it, I just have the one item here for you.
Yeah, the Nest Hub?
Yes.
All right, cool.
The Google something.
Terrible signature, but it
as
works.
As long as you know that a random person didn't pick it up, you're all good.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
That was very quick. You too, thank you.
Yeah. Where did you park?
That's insane. Oh my god, they were here when I got here. You guys saw it. Like, I barely had time to get the camera going. Absolutely insane. I don't even know where to go. That's, oh my god. Target. Good, you're good. All right, thank you. Thanks, Chicky Poo. I'd even check if it was the right one. Yeah, chalk. That was scary fast. I mean, you guys saw, I was pulling up with the camera. I'd even say I'm here in the app. Insane. I didn't expect it to be that fast. It's quite literally like a drive-through for tech or whatever you want, a toothbrush. I mean, if you want to buy a freaking toothbrush, you can. And you heard her. She said that they had multiple orders, obviously, because it's the weekend of Black Friday. Just... Wow. 100% rating. That was cool. That was really, really cool. Dude. All right, I'm going to go to Walmart, park over there, and we'll look at the product. All right, I am seriously blown away by how smooth that was. Oh, baby. I didn't plan on buying this a week ago. There it is. Nest Hub Max. They only have one in stock after this one. Dude. Oh, Target. That seriously felt like DoorDash for tech. I gotta be honest. As much as I love Amazon, I mean, come on, the convenience of packages being brought to you, to your house. Target? I mean, if there's something I really want that same day, and I'm just looking to save time, especially, again, if it's in the tech section behind glass, you gotta ask an associate to unlock the glass, you gotta go to checkout, blah, 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 wait in line. This could be really, really cool for the future. Big box, by the way. Huge box. Woo! Okay. I am done spending money on myself, at least for tech. Getting Taco Bell today. But Target, dude, 100% perfect experience. Now, is it usually like that off-season? I don't know. I guess I'll have to test it. But considering how busy everyone is today, and let me tell you, there's a ton of traffic over there in 30. So much traffic. They were quick. Like, they were literally there. You guys probably saw them on camera, right? I mean, like, they were literally right there. I mean, I wasn't even in park, I found out. I was in drive the whole time, just on my break. That's how quick it was. In and out in, like, 30 seconds. Mind blown. Okay. 5:05. I was probably in there for what, a couple hours? Man, Walmart is busy, but I gotta say the lines were not long. Thanks to self-checkout. I love self-checkout so much. Oh god. So I'm purposely not showing back there. I suddenly don't feel so guilty for buying myself the Nest Hub Max. Because I spent good amount of money on others today. And honestly, not one gift back there. Not one gift I planned on purchasing today. Walmart has a very good random selection. Especially for the person who has everything, you know? That's good. There's a couple gifts in there that I don't know, you know, what's for who. I'll just kind of figure it out as I go. But most gifts I bought today, like 90% of them, were bought for specific people. Okay? Guys, it's 5 o'clock. I have had nothing to eat today except for sausage. And that was kind of a late breakfast, but it was like 1 o'clock when I had that. 1:30. So, This is either a really late lunch at Taco Bell, which is where I'm going next, or it's an on-time dinner. Let's just call it an on-time dinner, because I rarely eat dinner at 5 o'clock. So this is good. And then tonight, when I get back, I want to unbox and set up my TV and my Nest Hub Max. I thought about dedicating videos to each product, but this vlog is going to be shorter than usual, so I'd rather include both experiences in this vlog. I hope you guys enjoy it. Now for the real question. What do I get at Taco Bell? I haven't tried those like new chicken taquito tornado type things. Are those any good? I mean, they seem cheap enough to the point where you're like, well, why not get them? Stay tuned. All right. Taco Bell was pretty busy, but I still had my food within like 10 minutes. Okay, first of all, I spilled Pepsi on my leg. Filled it up a little too much, a little leakage. It's okay, not a big deal. More for me, Boca. So, they're out of the rolled chicken tacos, they're called. I just couldn't think of the name. Rolled chicken tacos. They're completely sold out, which I guess is a good thing. They're popular. I did, however, get something new, which I've never tried before. And I'm not going to lie, I've been curious about this for a little while now. I mean, it's $1.29. I think it's called the Beefy Fritos Burrito. No beans, just a Beefy Fritos Burrito. So it's beef, Fritos, cheese sauce, and I guess that's it? For $1.29, why not? Oh, look at a little Frito. Crunchy. Alright, cheers. So I bit the edge of it, which means I didn't get like a lot of beef. Here we go. Good. Yo, that's damn good. And it's not only because of the Fritos. The Fritos are a bonus. For me, it's all about the cheese sauce. And I got 3 tacos. No, not bad. This adventure's not done yet. Next stop, Wawa. Oh, and of course, there's rice on there too. Hence it being a burrito. Sometimes I'm just really stupid. But yeah, I mean, for $1.29, it's pretty damn good. However, I'm still hoping to try the rolled chicken tacos. And I might be back here on either Monday or Tuesday with Mom. So I'll probably try them then. In Z Patrons only. I'm not mad, I just hate when I miss that button. You'd think with all the video games I play, I'd be more accurate. There you go. Yeah, babe. Okay, let's go. Maui? You up there? Go, Maui. Guys, I got so much done today. Yeah, I don't want to risk showing anything, just in case, you never know. Alright, got my Taco Bell, got my soda over here, got my coffee. But of course, my highlight of today was this. Oh, the Nest Hub Max. Dude, I'm so excited for this. So excited. This is just another reason why I'm not streaming tonight. I still have a lot to do. I mean, it's not like it's work or anything, but I definitely want to sit down with this and just enjoy the unboxing, enjoy the experience. I don't want to unbox it and immediately go on Twitch in an hour or whatever, because I still have to set up my TV too. And guys, that alone is a process. I might order my stand tonight, my dresser, TV stand. I don't know what I'm going to order yet. I got to look around. I got to scale back on my spending a bit, but I get paid by Patreon in a few days, so it's all good. Woo, I am looking at so many Christmas gifts, so many gifts. I love giving back. I love stuff. It's no secret. I'm surrounded by tech. But I'll say it again, when I say it every year. I love giving back. Just watching the person's reaction of opening a gift that I bought them, that I personally picked out for them, it's just an amazing feeling. It really is an amazing feeling. And I hope you guys can share that as well. I think I heard Maui. He may have just jumped off my bed. Maui! Better not have opened my TV. There he is. Come on, Maui. Hi. How was your day? Mine was great. I'm gonna unbox that later. Alright, so I'm going to enjoy my Taco Bell, guys. And there's a new show on Apple TV, a brand new show.
It's from M. Night Shyamalan. M. Night Shyamalan. I don't know how to say that. But yeah, in general, in my opinion, he makes good stuff. Not all good stuff. There's some movies where I'm like, aw, why? Why? But yeah, I was definitely a big fan of Signs and all that stuff. So yeah, The Servants, I'll let you know how episode one is. But first, let me eat. All right, I need food, guys. I barely ate anything today.
Is that the real Mr. Pants? This is a nice surprise. Hi, Hunter.
The other Mr. Pants?
I'm just stopping by real quick. Take him on the rudders.
Hi.
Jab me on my favorite. How are you? You're so cute.
Hopefully getting a free coffee and food.
How was your day, Mom?
Good, fun. I saw Kareen. We went to King of Prussia Mall. Went to casino.
Oh, how was it?
George Casino. Nice. I lost 20.
Is it big?
First to 117. It's actually not that big, but it's nice.
You only played 20?
Yeah, we played while we were waiting for Green to come down. And then we were tired by the time we left the mall. And even Kristen said, you want to go back in? I said, nope, I want to get home. She's like, me too.
What about Crane? Was she tired?
No, I don't think so.
Why'd you think?
Because I was thinking of something.
Kareen, I'm sorry I didn't go. I just wanted you guys to have your women's night out or day out.
You weren't up early enough for us.
And I had my solo day out.
I had 9 o'clock in her house.
Yeah. You had your day out. I had my day out. It was a good day. And I still don't box my TV in Google Home. Sorry, Nest Hub Max.
23
Were you by chance
say.
On 30 today?
Yes.
Wasn't it busy?
Yes, that's where the picture was I sent you.
Okay.
The Tesla.
A lot of traffic,
is
that right?
A nice Tesla?
Model X, right? Very nice. Starts at 81,000. Chump change. Crazy. Hi, Jazz. Have a cookie.
No, she's not a kitty.
You're so cute. So Taco Bell was good. It wasn't amazing. I mean, I just got general tacos. I will say my favorite thing out of all the stuff I got today was the burrito Fritos thing. But to be honest, they could have given me more beef. Most of it was rice. Taco Bell, come on. It was $1.29. Not going to complain too much. It was food. I will say, however, I didn't notice until after the fact, they gave me, I don't know if it was someone else's or they just made it by accident, a gordita crunch, I think? I didn't order it because I've only had that one.
I was going to say you were getting something different.
It was buried in the bag. I didn't see it until after the fact, and the shell by then is all soggy.
Wait, was it extra?
Put it in my fridge. Probably not going to eat it. Hi, Dad.
Why?
What's the matter?
Be cool, Dad.
We didn't leave anything in the hotel, did we? In the drawer?
No, why?
A pill case?
Back pill? But anyway, Taco Bell was good. And no, I didn't order that, Mom. They just put it in there by accident. I don't know how.
It's fine.
Taco Bell was busy. Every place is busy tonight. All right, you ready for, I almost said Waters.
It might be the front seat.
Yes.
Rudders?
Yeah, hon. We'll be back in 22 minutes.
Got my coffee for free, by the way, earlier.
No, I gotta go because the brownie's gonna be done.
There's the cute one with the big butt.
Yes.
Dark hair?
Yes. We're sneaking behind her real quick.
Yeah, I told her. I'm like, thank you.
Keep on her.
Oh, wait, she gave you free?
Yeah.
Yeah, she gives us free.
But I got a tornado, too. Tornado. Dad. You want coffee?
Yes.
Yeah? Cool. I'll be back. And I'm home again. Blah, 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 blah. Can't show gifts. That was a very quick visit to Mom and Dad's house. I will be there again tomorrow for dinner. Got a little honey bun from Rudder's. My mom sent me home with some apple pie. Oh, baby. Leftover water from before. And more coffee. That's the second time I went to Rudder's today. And once to Wawa. What can I say? I enjoy spreading my convenience store love all over the place. Guys. Hey, Siri. What time is it? 9:50. Let's just say 10 o'clock. Hold on. I'm sick of your attitude. You gotta calm down. Seriously. Calm down! I'm finally gonna unbox my TV and Nest Hub Max. I mean, it's not that I don't care. Obviously I do, just today was a busy shopping day, you know? Then I watched 3 episodes of Servant, which by the way was really good.
It's the kind of show that makes you think, like, what is the truth here? So yeah, I mean, if you're into like thriller slash horror, drama, whatever you want to call it, definitely check it out. Apple TV Plus has yet to disappoint me. So now that's three shows, three brand new shows that I've invested in. The Morning Show, C, and Servant. Can't be a coincidence. Apple, you're on the right track. Okay, I'm going to go up there and get my shower. And then I'm going to unbox my TV and then this, the Nest Hub Max. So guys, stay tuned. It may be 10 o'clock, but in my eyes, the nut is young. Because, well, I'm not streaming. I mean, as much as I love streaming on Twitch, I especially enjoy the freedom that I have at night when I'm not streaming on Twitch. For example, I can unbox this and take my good old time. I'm just a little worried about it fitting on there. Again, it's going to hang off like a mother. The weight will be fine. It just comes down to the placement of the legs. Where is it going to sit on here? If anything, we might just make it. And if worse comes to worse, I can't use the TV tonight. Not a big deal. Set it aside for a couple days until I get some furniture. Bunch of perverts. Hey, Maui. Have you guys been waiting this whole time? Guys, I'm gonna heat up my coffee, and then we're going to unbox the TV. Oddly enough, I think I'm more excited for the Nest Hub Max. I mean, obviously I'm hyped for the TV, but the Nest Hub Max, I'm very, very interested to see if I like it more than my Echo Show, because I love my Echo Show. And no, I'm not taking it down. It's gonna stay in my kitchen. I'm just gonna change its placement. There's enough room for both, guys. Literally. And then at some point tonight, when I'm done with everything, all the unboxings, I had to come into my gaming room. Hey Siri, turn on the gaming room lights. And set up my overlay. This PC hasn't been on in days. It's been busy with other things. Yeah, I believe I found a free Christmas overlay over at nerdordie.com that I can use in my Twitch streams. And if you want the same overlay, I'll link it right below. It should be free. Okay, what is the best way to go about this? Let's see the TV first. Come on. This is pretty heavy, by the way. And ignore my messy bed. Again, everything will be better once the party is ready to start. This is a much better way of wording that. Okay, unboxing a 65-inch TV by yourself should be very, very interesting. I guess I'll start by opening this and seeing how it's packaged. It's properly packaged. Nice clean cut. Got the edges here too. There you go. Little cut. Boom. Never cut towards you like I'm doing now. Like that. Not very safe. Caution! Read this first. Okay. Do not return to store. We are ready to help! Well, I hope I don't have to return it to the store. That would be a pain. Yeah, it's showing two people. So, just like my Samsung TV in there, which, by the way, is 55-inch. Ironically, this one is much bigger and much cheaper. But at the same time, this one, in theory, is better quality because it's Samsung. And plus, I don't need 65-inch in here. 55-inch, honestly, I think is the right size for this setup. I mean, look at that. It's so balanced. Even with that display over there, I thought it would look unbalanced, but the PC actually balances out with the monitor, right? Okay, so back to this TV. Like my Samsung, you do want to unbox it from the bottom, like that. So those plastic things right there, 1, 2, 3, there should be 6 total. Take them out, and the box, in theory, should slide right up after cutting I guess, the other side of the box in terms of the tape.
Here are the feet, or the legs, whatever you want.
Let's just call it the stand. Here's the stand for the TV. Plastic, nothing fancy.
And then the next step is you want to take the foam out, but not the TV out yet. Come on! Damn, this thing is packaged well, that's for sure. That's a big piece of foam, look at that. That's a giant piece of foam.
Look at Maui getting all excited. Don't worry, Maui. Once the TV's out, you can go in here and play. Alright, so now I guess I gotta take these out. Maybe just squeeze them. Looks like it. Give me 1 minute.
Okay, got all these clips out. And by the way, it really helps to have a knife. That way you can kind of cram it in the corner, pinch it, and this little lever kind of folds downward and you pull it out. Pretty cool. That is something my Samsung did not have. Teleportation! Okay, this should just rise, right? Or raise right out. Rise, raise. Let's just go with both. Hell yeah. That is a big TV, dude. Holy shit.
Oh my god, there's something attacking these plastic things. What is it? Some kind of creature. Some kind of creature. Get it. Oh my god. Oh, it's Maui. Okay. Hey, Maui. What are you doing? What are you doing? What are you doing? You're Uncle Key. Okay, now for the scary part. I gotta take this out and put it against the wall. All by myself. By the way, you may have noticed, it says Fragile? This must be Italian. That's interesting. Maui, get, come on. Now, get. Psst. Come on, dude, go. Psst. Come on. Psst. Get. Nothing personal. Alright, TV's laying flat, which is fine. Which is fine, it's not exactly 2004 anymore. So these stands are out, and please ignore all my clothes. This will be taken care of. I mean, in a way, this is kind of like a behind the scenes of how David really lives. Okay, so the stands are out. I'm going to first get a screwdriver just to make sure I'm prepared for this. And then I'll take care of the rest. Yeah. It's not hard. It's just, again, I'm doing this by myself, so it's a big TV. I'll just say that. It's a pretty big TV.
Okay. It was actually a little more challenging than I thought, because the stand is weird. The stand has these little nips, if you will, that look like they go into a slot, but they don't. They kind of like sit against the TV, but there is like a little slither that it sits on, but not like, I don't know, it doesn't click in like I was expecting. However, the stand is installed.
And as you can see, the TV is actually upside down. Because at first I was working on the ground like this, and I was propping it up with pillows, that way it would flex naturally. But that proved to be a little difficult. So, I think we're good. Now, I'm going to measure between the stands to see how much space we have over there. My room is a mess right now. But that's a good problem to have, my friends, because I'm unboxing a freaking 65-inch TV! Something I didn't expect to do this weekend. Which is incredible. Okay, let's measure.
Okay, so between the stands, about 40 and a half inches. Now, what does this weigh? Okay, 47 inches wide. We're good.
While it will fit with plenty of room for the stand, I still plan on getting a much, much better, more elegant, more modern-looking stand. And again, in case you missed it in the beginning of the vlog, this is actually going in the basement alongside with my storage for everything else, like all my old gear, old tech, old consoles. It's going to look sweet. Actually, this TV is going down there too. Guys, if you haven't noticed, I love TVs. and monitors. I'm kind of obsessed, actually. But these things are so damn affordable nowadays, you just gotta ask yourself, why not? Okay, let's get it on there and hope it doesn't collapse.
I never use this light. It's pretty cool, though. It's touch. Love it. Okay, TV's unplugged. Apple TV's unplugged. Oh, hi. There you go. Just like that. Another TV to add to the vault. What if God was one of us? I'm not even going to bother properly dusting it. I'm just kind of, oh God! What was I thinking? Yeah, because this thing's coming out of here in a matter of weeks, so I'm not going to bother putting too much thought into it. Okay. Moment of truth. So, I still have the protective plastic on. That way, if I touch the bezels, I don't get it all smudgy. It's standing up. It's a good sign. Now to get it up here. Let's move that out of the way. And here we go. It's so damn big. Maui, you gotta go, dude. I gotta turn it around first. It's not the thinnest TV, as you can probably tell, but again, for less than $300, I don't expect insane build quality. It's definitely got some good weight to it, though. Okay. Woo! I definitely need a second person. So much harder by yourself. Let's go from the front. My hoodie's nice and soft. I'm not going to scratch the screen. Ah! Move, lamp! Woo! This thing is massive! Holy shit! I definitely need a new stand. Oh my god. Upgrading from 50 inch to 65 inch is truly a huge upgrade. For the time being, I'm going to shift this all the way down. That way it fills the space a little more, and I'm literally blocking my door. That's how big this TV is, guys. Alright, I'm going to get this situated, and we'll power it up. And by the way, side note, where did I put that? The remote looks pretty sweet. Look at that. Netflix, Vudu, YouTube, Google Play, Assistant. Google Assistant, that is, and ignore that stain. I'm getting it cleaned. That's Maui Vom. That's what cats do. Anyway, Google Assistant, so I could be like, hey, Google, blah, 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 all that stuff. Cool. And yes, the batteries are included. I just got to put them in. Man, it's a Google kind of day, isn't it? Okay, here we go. Enough talking. Okay, I plugged it in and it just powered on. Cool. Now to take the tape off. It's so loud. I got to say, guys, for a TV of this price, the packaging isn't bad. It's not bad at all. Very, very well protected. Thin bezel, too. Look at that. Surprisingly thin bezel for a TV less than $300. Not bad at all. I'm trying to touch the screen. I think tonight I will research some furniture. So maybe I will be buying myself one more thing before the holidays. Because I definitely want this to look nice. And right now, it just looks ridiculous. It looks really, really bad. I'm thinking some rustic-themed furniture, like the tables I have in my gaming room. I'm just into that dark wood vibe right now. Plus, it goes well with my white bed, which needs to be made. I don't believe in making my bed unless I have company coming over. Goodbye, old TV. Hello, new TV. This is my typical 4K test with new displays and monitors and TVs and whatever.
This is a video shot by me. iPhone 6S 4K montage. It looks great. I mean, for a TV less than 300, I know I'm saying that a lot, looks damn good.
I don't know how much I'm going to use the NTV software. I'm not
usually a big fan of that. I would much rather use my Apple TV. But considering all this is built in, I mean, Netflix, Vudu, YouTube, Google Play, all that stuff, it's not bad. Not bad. And it looks great. But going back here, this is what I'll see in bed now. Man, talk about a massive upgrade. That thing is enormous. It looks so good. Woo! Not something I expected to do this weekend. Very cool. And it does have Google Assistant. What's happening next Tuesday? I don't know. I'm just playing around with it. So there you go. Just, yeah, brings up videos and whatever. Will it snow tomorrow? You don't listen to
There's
snow tomorrow.
There's a chance of snow in Leacock Township late tomorrow night.
I'm not in Leacock. I gotta finish that. I mean, I'll fix that. But yeah, it's built in. Again, not a feature I'll use really, because I'm just going to use my Apple TV for pretty much everything. I love my Apple TV. I use it every single day, upstairs and downstairs. Isn't that right, Maui? All of this is just a nice bonus. I just wanted a size upgrade, you know? And totally worth it. From 50 inches to 65, that's pretty big. Okay, what do you say we go downstairs and unbox this, finally? And I haven't even turned on my PC yet. I gotta work on my Twitch overlay. There's always tomorrow night, but I definitely want to get a head start tonight. Overlays require a lot of work. Okay, one more comment. And look at that, you guys are in bed with me. This is where I normally sit at night. God, that is seriously so much bigger. It might not look big on camera, but when you're so used to looking at that TV, and then you go from there to that, damn. Look at that. The light even hits the ceiling a lot closer. That's crazy. This might become my new annual tradition on Black Friday. Just buy a TV. Why not? Okay, now let's go downstairs. Didn't even touch my coffee. But yeah, tonight I am looking forward to going to bed and just watching The Office, Apple TV Plus, or Disney Plus, whatever.
Oh, no.
Love the show.
Not weird at all.
God, that's hot. I'm eating brownies, drinking my coffee. Alright guys, this is going to be a very basic unboxing. I'm not going to walk you through the setup process. However, stay tuned for future videos and future vlogs and all that good stuff. Where I walk you through the features, like my favorite features and all that stuff. But we will do the initial unboxing together. This is very exciting. Again, I got this for $199 on sale. It's normally, I think, $229? So I saved like $30. And this is my first official Target drive-up purchase, which is pretty cool. Also, I forgot my Apple TV upstairs isn't even 4K, so I might get a 4K Apple TV for upstairs in the near future. I have one down here. I use it all the time, and ironically, my bedroom TV is bigger than a TV I have down here. This is, I think, 55, but speaking in terms of quality, the Samsung is visually better because it's Samsung. It costs more. It's got better specs and all that stuff. However, with that said, the 65-inch Samsung from in the basement will come up here. So in a month's time, I'll have a 65-inch TV in my bedroom, a 55-inch in my gaming room, and a 65-inch down here in my living room, and a 50-inch and 46-inch, two TVs, in the basement for something. I don't know. And now my 42-inch monitor in my office, and 3 27-inch displays in my gaming room, and a 20-inch display in my gaming room. I love monitors. Alright, here we go. Nest Hub Max. Oh. I'll wait here. That took a while. Oh my god, dude. Holy shit. Woohoo. It seriously looks like an iPad. Look at that. It's right there when you open up the box. Very nice. I believe there's dual speakers in here, plus a 3-inch woofer. Yes, it has a dedicated subwoofer. It's surprisingly light. We got that symmetrical design. Lenovo. I think I said that word. Lenovo, I'm looking at you. I'm sure you guys make quality products, but your smart speaker is disgusting. What the hell were you thinking with that left-aligned speaker with the display on the right? Always go symmetrical when it comes to stuff that's going to be in your kitchen, your living room, your office. You want it to look nice. You want it to look nice. And this looks really nice. And the camera is what sold me, besides the large screen. Again, this is a Nest camera, so in a way, you're saving a lot of money. But don't forget, it's not a dedicated Nest camera in the sense that you can move it freely, you know, angles and whatever, and it doesn't have night vision. But with that said, in early 2020 sometime, I know that's like the theme of this video, I will be getting more Nest cams. This is going to be a Nest-powered house, which is inspired by my Nest thermostat. Normally I'd go with Alexa, but because of my Nest thermostats, I just want everything tied together under the same brand. But I'll say it one more time, and I'm sure I'll say it in the future. I'm not done with my Echo devices. I love my Echo devices. I'm not done with my HomePod. I love my HomePods. Got one of each. But I'm definitely going to make this a Nest-centric household. Okay, let's get started. That's what it says. I don't think I need this. Microphones, camera, blah, blah, blah. We have a white power adapter with Google branding on the back. Very nice. Or the front. You know what? I guess the front. And is that it? I think that's it. Very simple packaging. That's all. All right. I think I'm actually going to set this up right here so I can enjoy some TV in the background, enjoy my coffee, my brownie, and all that stuff. So I'm going to plug it in right here and get it set up. And I'll update you guys.
There's a box.
And there you have it. Very nice. So mute your Google devices, all right? Your Android devices, all that stuff. Here we go. 3, 2, 1. Hey, Google. Open Spotify.
All right. Here are your recommended playlists.
Hey, Google. Volume 8. Hey, Google. Play Christmas classics on Spotify.
Okay, the Spotify playlist called Christmas Classics. Here you go.
Pretty cool. Now, obviously, I've seen all this stuff before. But to have it on a display this large is pretty cool. Hey, Google. Volume 3. Now, gotta be perfectly honest with you guys, I'm a little disappointed. I saw this the second I booted it. Not gonna return it, but I do have one dead pixel right there. You see that? It's barely noticeable if you're not looking for it, and if there's dark colors up there, you honestly can't even see it. So it's not a big deal. Not a big deal, just something I'll have to get over. Hey Google, next song. I just hate when stuff like that happens, but you know what? It's not a life ender, guys. Life goes on. What can I say? I'm incredibly picky. I take pride in that. Alright, so let me see if this works with my Christmas tree by default. It's on HomeKit, which is Apple's thing. I'm curious. Hey Google, turn off the Christmas tree.
Nothing's playing right now.
Yeah. I just gotta set it up. So if you swipe down from up here, you can set up your rooms and everything, which I haven't really done yet. Of course, I still have a lot to do. But my thermostat is set. Check it out, because it's automatically a Nest product, so everything is integrated. I currently have 65 downstairs, and the mode is obviously set to heat. Go back by swiping left, swipe down. It's a little finicky right there. Go back to thermostats, and of course, there's upstairs as well. Hey, Google, set the upstairs thermostat to 60 degrees.
Okay, setting upstairs to 60 degrees.
Cool. Now, apparently, you can do multiple commands in one. So, let me see. Hey, Google, set the upstairs thermostat to 65 and open Spotify.
Sure, setting upstairs to 65 degrees. Here are some recommended playlists.
Okay. Cool. I'm curious to see how many apps she can go through back and forth. Let's see. Hey, Google. Open YouTube. Open Spotify. Open YouTube. Open Spotify.
Which one would you like?
Okay, never mind. Okay. By the way, these are my pictures you're seeing from New York City, 2015. I took these years ago. I love this photo. However, one of my favorites is around here somewhere. Whoops, didn't mean to do that. Hold on. What the? I guess I reached the end of the slideshow. Unless, hold on, maybe. Oh, there we go. Oh, I got a okay, I see. Here you go. I love that picture. I love that so much. Hey, Google, show me pictures of dogs. Just something stupid,
showing
you know?
Pictures that match.
Okay. Let me see something. Hey, Google, show me my pictures of dogs.
Sure. To help you with that, I need your permission to allow personal results on this device. You can turn on personal results in settings in the Google
okay.
Home app.
Cool. So, it can do it in theory. It's currently 32 degrees out. So, everything is pretty much set up through here. You can see I have my Google Home Mini, which I have to delete. Nest Cam is being viewed. Did you see that? So, basically, when I open the app or show the camera, I think it was technically being viewed. Okay, there we go. Nest Cam being viewed. Basically, it's telling me that I'm in the app. And somebody's using my camera. So connecting. There you go. It's not 16 by 9. But again, you have to factor in. This is a bonus security camera in a way. And it's going to be going in my kitchen. So in theory, I should get like a widescreen view of. Not widescreen, I'm sorry. Wide angle view of my, my kitchen. I'm a little tired if you can't tell. Oh, and of course, for you privacy freaks, check this out. There is a switch on the back. Listen.
The mic and camera are off.
Turn it back on.
The mic and camera are back on.
Now, there is no physical shutter, which in my opinion, they should include. But, not a big deal. I mean, it's me we're talking about, guys. I'm not a privacy advocate at all. And the volume is on the side if you don't want to use voice commands. Oh! Speaking of commands, I have not tried the hand gesture yet, so let's try that real quick. Hey, Google, play Chris's music on Spotify.
Okay, here's a Spotify playlist called Christmas Classics.
Hey, Google. Volume 4. Okay, so you have to be looking at the camera and raise your hand. Holy shit, it actually worked! Dude! Watch. Wow. That is really cool. Now, that's useful for one, if your hands are wet and you don't feel like using your voice for whatever reason. And number two, if you're in an incredibly noisy environment and for whatever reason you can't yell, hey, blah, blah, blah. It's actually pretty cool. All right, so let's try my left hand. Yeah. Wow. Dude. That works very well. Hey, Google, volume 8. Hey, Google, play the latest tech news.
Here's the latest technology news. Your news update will have fresh stories picked just for you every time you ask to play the news. Resuming CNET at 11:46 p.m. yesterday.
Twitter support. The company said it had heard concerns and would not remove inactive accounts until it created
a Google,
new way for people.
Go home.
To memorialize
I'm curious if I can turn my TV on.
Black Friday may have
what?
Come and gone.
Hey Google, but the sales exit. I gotta get used to that. Okay. Let me see something. Hey Google, turn on my TV.
I couldn't turn on your TV. Please consult with your TV manual or manufacturer on whether this is supported.
Okay. I didn't expect that. Let me try one more time. Hey, Google. Turn on my bedroom TV.
I couldn't turn on your TV. Please consult with your TV manual or manufacturer.
Obviously, I don't need that. I just figured I'd try. So, there you go, guys. I mean, it's exactly what I expected. The only thing that really surprises me is how well that works. Wow! So it automatically resumed the last video app. Even if I'm going home, watch. Hey, Google. Exit. Hey, Google. Exit. That was my fault. I talked a little fast. Now, if I do this...
huge savings on tech.
That is neat.
$200 off the price of the new MacBook.
Okay.
Okay. While Target is offering...
I'm like a freaking Jedi. Look how well it works.
A Pro for a massive $300 off. Meanwhile, Walmart has big discounts on the place...
It's pretty much perfect. That is cool. Okay, guys. I am going to give you a break from all this tech madness. I'm going to chill, watch the Boy Meets World. Maybe make coffee, even though I'm drinking a Rutter's coffee. Because I want to get started on my Twitch overlay. Because I know tomorrow I'm not going to have a lot of time between editing this vlog, which is longer than I expected, going to Mom and Dad's for dinner, cleaning the house tomorrow night when I get back, because the party is less than 2 weeks. And I just want to start getting things in order. So, I guess I'll say goodbye now, and I'll see you guys tomorrow? Is that cool with you? Man, today was a good day. Today was a really, really good day. I bought some good tech for myself. I did some Christmas shopping for others. I'm gonna have me some Taco Bell. Set out my new TV, which is great. I love upgrades, and speaking of, I gotta continue researching some TV stands. Okay, guys, I'm gonna let you go here. I'll see you tomorrow. Hello, Father.
Okay, get a little closer.
Now. I'm vlogging.
Hi.
What are you doing?
Hanging ornaments on a rotating tree. You know, my pan. It's a good thing and a bad thing.
Yes, your tree is rotating and wobbling.
Either that or the room is wobbling.
It looks really cool, Dad. Good job. LEDs, I presume?
Yes.
Yeah, they're nice
and
cool.
And that's why I need your remote control.
They're nice and cool.
So I can change them.
Isn't there an app?
No, it's just on all the time. It's stupid.
Are you sure there's no app, Dad? You guys like it? I like it a lot. Guys, what another productive day. The vlog is over an hour long, which makes me happy. Started cleaning the house for the Christmas party. Put things away. Threw a bunch of stuff out. Cleaned out my fridge. Put some things away in my bedroom, which I'll finish tonight. Very productive weekend in general.
Is actually clean?
I just gotta scrub it down.
That's
which I'll do like maybe a day or two before. Because you know, man, it's just gonna get dirty again.
No, we had to load it up with stuff.
Well, no, exactly. Dad, when we're ready to load it is when I'll clean it. There's shelves. It takes 5 minutes. And shout out to my patrons. I haven't transferred the money yet, but 'twas a good month. Was a good month. I'm just waiting for it to withdraw, which I'll do tomorrow. Thank you guys so much for your support. And speaking of, have you guys enjoyed this vlog on this camera? I know the low light's not the best, but you do get that wide angle view, 60 frames per second. It's easy to bring around with me, hence why I brought it over the weekend, not the Sony camera.
Let it go off.
I noticed that. The switch is updating, so the Christmas tree is off. Hey, Jazz. About to get warm up in her. You're so cute, you know that? You're so cute. Jamman. Boo-boo! Best dog ever. Look at that face.
It's really hot, Dave. Potatoes are hot. Don't
wake him.
Don't even tell him. He's going to burn himself and learn his lesson. So what's for dinner, Mom?
Don't look at this messy counter. Fried pork chops. I'm having grilled cheese.
Pork chops. Hungry Jack potatoes with cheese, guys, and paprika. God, if you've never tried Hungry Jack potatoes, oh, no, guys, you need to try them like this. They are stellar. And some leftover rice from Thanksgiving. Hungarian recipe. It is so good. So, so good. And good news, I did finish my Christmas overlay tomorrow. For the first time, I'm actually... Okay, I didn't do my alerts, which means I'll probably do that tonight. The only thing I don't like about this camera is these lines around LEDs. Doesn't really play well. It's not this camera's fault. It's just 60 frames in general. Anyway, didn't work on my alerts yet. but the actual overlay itself looks so good. For the first time ever, I used an overlay or a graphics or whatever that's not GIFs. Not GIFs, it is GIFs. The creator of the GIF acronym said it is GIF. Just throwing that out there.
I say GIF.
Thank you, that's what it is. You would think it's GIF, but it's actually GIF, like the peanut butter. Anyway, they're actually media sources, so it looks pretty cool. I hate vlogging in this kitchen now. I used to love it, but these lines drive me absolutely crazy.
What lines?
The line, but it's a refresh rate issue.
Oh, sorry.
I'm all triggered. Guys, it's 8:46. We had dinner. Thank you very much for dinner, Mom.
You're welcome.
Mom's picking up balls.
Please don't show me.
We watched Christmas Chronicles on Netflix, guys. It was actually quite good.
Is it Netflix movie or was it out last year?
Netflix exclusive. Just like Holiday Rush. It was out last year. Where's the remote? Yeah. Hence why they kept saying 2018. Which is pretty cool. So they actually aligned it with our time. But yeah, Netflix exclusive, The Christmas Chronicles. I say it was actually good because I think most people are going to agree. Most Christmas movies in recent years have been kind of blah. Like, they haven't really been that great. But that one was actually quite good. It was funny. It was a little bit of a tearjerker here and there. All around a good movie. I love Awesome Powers. It's so good. Mom.
Yes.
Rudders, let's go. I love that sound. Usually means you're about to watch a good movie. And I'm home. Look what I did before. God, it's amazing what an hour of cleaning can do. Now, I haven't scrubbed everything down, including in here. But look at that difference. My God. What a difference some cleaning can make, guys. There's the advent calendar. Patrons, I hope you enjoy Countdown to Christmas 2019 Day 1. Hey, Maui. I'm signing off. And of course, we gotta say hi to Maui. Hi. How are ya? You're a good guy. Alright, guys. It is time to finish editing this video. Look at that. Another video I have to edit. By the way, I didn't even mention, I edited a brand new end screen, two end screens for the vlogs, which you'll probably see at the end of this video. Yeah, because this classifies as a holiday video. But before I go, I want to give one special shout out to a brand new $25 patron. I haven't looked up the details yet, but he is linked right below. If he gets me my link in time for this, check him out. I appreciate it. I appreciate your support. Thank you so much, dude. I would personalize as part of the video, but unfortunately I'm short on details unless he happened to email me back today. Otherwise, there's only so much I can say. Hold on, let me see. Give me 1 second. I'm picking up a lot of patrons this weekend. Thank you guys so much. I appreciate it very much. You are quite literally changing my life. Nothing. But either way, if he does get me the link in time, I'll link it right below. Guys, thank you very much. I hope you had a wonderful Thanksgiving weekend. Hopefully spend it with those you love, whether that's your family, your friends, whoever. I was going to say something very poetic. It just sounded stupid when I said it out loud, so I cut it out. Anyway, guys, I appreciate those around you. We're all in this together. That's all I'm trying to say. Happy Thanksgiving. Happy Black Friday. And why not? I hope you guys had a great weekend, a great and safe weekend. And of course, I will see you in many holiday videos throughout the next few weeks. I'll see you then. Peace. This thing is still amusing to me. It's so cool. Lucky tick. Oh my God. I'm so sorry, Frosty. Here, take your nose. I was trying to show you this. What? How do you... Oh. Oh God. He's falling apart.